Hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got a G501J ASUS laptop, and the problem is the power jack, at least that's what the client tells us. Well, it is the power jack because it's not there. Let me show you. Right there, there is no jack inside of that hole. So I'm gonna take it apart, and hopefully I'm gonna be able to fix it up. This is a Torx 5, and most of the screws are missing. There's only just one screw holding everything down here. My understanding, the client removed the hard drive prior to shipping. So that's how you take it off, right here. That's the jack that's been bouncing all over the motherboard, probably shorted a few components right here. Because the battery was connected. So I don't think it's, even if I replace the jack, I'm not sure if it's gonna work, because again the battery was connected. A couple of things, we had screws under those two pads right here and right here. And when the client was taking it apart, he didn't remove this guy right here. And that's the reason why you're watching those videos, so that you need to take it apart properly. So like that, and there's a screw right here and a screw right there that you need to unscrew before you're gonna take this whole thing apart. Now let's remove the screw here. All right, and let's remove the broken screw right here. All right. So the first thing to do here is to disconnect the battery. It's pretty obvious to disconnect the battery. And just unscrew the battery from the laptop itself. Alright, so this one was a small black tiny screw for some reason. I was thinking they're all the same screw, but they are not. So let's remove this. And now let's zoom in a little bit. And hopefully the focus is alright, right? Yeah, okay. So we're gonna disconnect this hinge right here. Right here, right here, and right there. By the way, if at any point in time you will find that the video was useful, please leave a like. Thank you so much. Alrighty, so here we're just gonna disconnect this guy. Hold it like that. This guy like that, set aside. Alright. We have a little bridge connecting the two motherboards. And the hard drive right here, so we're gonna disconnect the hard drive. Alright, so we're disconnecting the hard drive. Like that. And the three screws right here. Alright, wonderful. Let's disconnect this board. Alright. And we got three screws for the fan right there. One, all right, so three screws for the fan, and here we just connect the fan right here, and probably there is a bracket underneath the heatsink that holds it all downwards. Alrighty, this is you pull upwards, and at the same time you're trying to kind of pick it up from this end right here. And here you wanna disconnect the screw right there. Right there. And right there. Okay. Good job. Here we got a broken piece. You want to remove everything that's broken because that's going to short the motherboard if it's going to be bouncing all over the board. Probably what happened in this case. Alrighty. By the way, it's easier to remove the connector when it's on the motherboard because right now the pins are being stuck, the connector's pins are stuck in the motherboard. Hopefully there's going to be much more light in here. Alright. Let's continue working on this thing. Screw right there. Right here. One right here. Alright, so that screw was not supposed to be there. That's a silver screw. That's supposed to hold the battery down. It shouldn't be holding the motherboard down. So, my understanding, somebody was taking this whole thing apart before. And let's unscrew the fan here. Even though the fan probably could stay in place. But just in case. One screw right here. Alright. Alright, let's see. Yep, the screws for the fan could have stayed in place for sure. Not for the left one. Not this one right here, which had to come out. But I'm talking about this one right here. Alright. Let's inspect and see. Doesn't look that great, honestly. Doesn't look that great, the prior attempt, that's what doesn't look that great. What's all this garbage right here? Right, seems like that's the flux. Anyways, here, let's lift up this component right here because it's all gonna melt. Cut this out. And now what I have to do, I'm gonna put some Kapton tape on top of the motherboard right next to where the jack was because the hot air from the hot air station gonna melt everything around the connector if it's not being protected. So we're gonna do it like that, and this guy right here might, well, let me put the screws back onto the fan because the fan gonna bounce around. Alright, so that's one screw. And that's the second screw. Alright, this component almost always flies off the motherboard, so you have to be extremely careful. Now there is a reflection from the tape, so it's not really that high quality. Anyways, let's go to the soldering station and show me how to... I'm gonna show you how to take this connector off. Alrighty, so we're gonna power up the hot air, the soldering iron. Alright. Just a little bit of hot air. Let's add some flux right there, and right there at all four points. And let's use the desoldering wick to desolder the excess. You see, if it would be just the jacket, it would just come out right away. In this case, we have to work with it. Spend a lot more time working on this thing. And hit the board for much longer than needed to get all of those. Soldering points cleaned up. All right, looks good to me. Yep. All right, so I got a brand new jack right here. We're gonna just put some flux right here, and right there. Then let's put the new jack right in here. Alright, it doesn't want to go in. Because this pad right here is damaged from... That's a component from the prior repair. This trace right here is damaged. So the way to repair it is by trying to flood it with flux and then add some solder. You see, the reason we use hot air is so that the traces like that wouldn't be damaged. But here, because the client was probably using the soldering iron, which is fine. I mean, I could get this job done with just, you know, if you give me hot nail, a nail that, and a stove, I could heat up the nail on the stove and desolder this whole thing, you know, it's no big deal, but you just have to be, you have to know what you're doing here. And, yeah, right there, I can see that it's no use. All right, so let's flood it one more time. Oh, by the way, it seems like... Oh, it's all good. Let's flood it one more time. Let's add some hot air to this. All right. A little bit farther away because this is gonna be too close. All right, let's see. Nope, it doesn't wanna. It's all kind of messed up right there. Alrighty. I need to kind of correct it, I guess. You probably don't have to do that, but here, let's try and straighten this hole so that it would be a nice real hole right here. Right there. Still, I don't think the whole leg gonna fit through. Alrighty. Alright, let's try one more time. Alright, it went through just fine. Let's add the... Let's position it like that. Now the goal is to add some flux right here, right here, right here, and right there. Alright, let's drop it all down like that. And let's solder this guy in place. Okay, looks good to me. Let's flip this guy over like that. And... Alright, so there's some little bit here, little bit there. The key is to use as much flux as possible. There is never too little, there is never too much flux there is. So, yeah, looks good to me. Wonderful, let's take this guy off of here. See if all of the components are still intact. Yep, like that. Let's see if this guy is still intact. Yep, it's all good. And none of the components got stuck to the captain tape. Alright, a couple of things. I need to clean up this stuff right here. I need to clean up this guy right there. Right there, right there. And I need to clean up with 99% ISP right here. Alrighty. Let's do a little bit rubbing into right there. Right here, right there. There's a fine tips that let me penetrate. Kind of agitate the whatever flux people used before. Alright, I'm just agitating it. I'm not cleaning anything yet. I'm just agitating the ISP into those little tiny components and all around the connection. Alrighty. Alright, so once everything is agitated, alright, really well agitated. Now we're gonna bring a Q-tip. And we're gonna just polish it a little bit, so to speak. Like that. And now the dry end. And the dry end just gonna polish it a little bit as well. Alright, so now we're gonna again do the same thing right here. Already, and now is the dry connection, dry end right here. like that. And it looks just like factory. So here I just wanna remove all of these flags from this end. Clean up all of those unnecessary stuff from my mat. The mats from China became really expensive nowadays. I mean, they used to be $1, now they're $9. So you used to, once you, you know, go through all of those, you just keep buying a new one. But now the inflation is killing the business. So, yeah. And we might want to probably even clean up this pad right here. Because of the excess... Right, let's rub it into here. But those pads are meant to be under high heat, so they are should be alright. Alright, so here you see how well the ISP cleans up this gooey. Alright, good job. Okay, enough of that. Let's assemble it back together. Alrighty. What we're gonna do here is put it like that. Okay. And probably like that. Like that. Where are my gloves? Because the edges are cutting my fingers. Those gloves are amazing because they're not letting my... Uh-oh. Wrong camera. Hold on 1 second. Yeah. Like that. And let's deal with the autofocus. Alrighty, so here this thing's supposed to go down like that. Okay, just 1 second here. Like that. Like that. Like that. Like that. And like that. You know what, I think we kind of have to put it like that all together. Alrighty. Okay, good job. Let's change the field of view a little bit so you could see much better everything. So we connected this guy, that guy, and that guy. Make sure this line is exactly on that other line. Alrighty, so here we're just gonna connect it like that. Close it down like that. Yep. Okay. Let's screw down those big fat screws going in right here. I think, yeah. I wonder if that's the screw for the top. Oh, nope, sorry. Alright, so this is not it here. This one. Okay. So two long screws going in right there. One shorter. Well, not quite here. Much shorter screw going in right here. Nope, doesn't go in right there. That's not the right screw. Nope, I don't see the right screw in here. Probably, you know what? Hold on one second. This is not even. This is a screw that's supposed to go from the top down, probably. You know what? Hold on. Yeah, so whoever was taking it apart messed up all of the screws around here. So, let's see. Alright, so you see how slightly different. So this screw goes here, that screw goes here. Alright, those two go from the top.
Okay.
Good job. Now, let's put it back in. Okay. And you see how right here that's improper, all right? Whoever took it apart before, they jammed the wireless cables under the hinge and they damaged the wireless cables. You see, this is not supposed to be happening like that. You see? Right there. Alright, so what you wanna do is you wanna guide those guys over. Again, that's probably doesn't apply to you because you're watching this video. But the point remains that you have to be careful about looking what you're doing here. Okay. Now my goal is to insulate every one of those wires because they probably got exposed. Probably, yeah. Had to take my gloves off because the gloves get stuck to those to the tape, and I sometimes can't do anything here. Yeah, like that. Good job. Good job. All right, let's do screw right here. Screw right there. And another screw right here. Okay. Don't over torque it, kind of. Don't let me use a much lighter. Just some finger tightening right here. So that's like that. Then we got another screw going in right there. No, hold on. One going in right here. All right, so this is all connected. We still have some missing screws because that's not how it's supposed to be here. One going in right here. Another screw going in right there. Okay. Now let's connect the hard drive together with the bracket. Oh, so it doesn't connect together. It's just there for structural support. My understanding is that, yeah. All right, so here we're gonna screw down this guy. We're gonna screw down that guy. And we're gonna screw down this guy right here. Okay. Now, one screw right there. Another screw right here. Alrighty. Open this guy up, open this guy up. Close that right there. Let's close this guy right here. Looks okay, but not as good as I hope. Okay. I wonder if there's a screw going through right here, which I don't have. Maybe not, maybe it's just there like that. Okay, so this is connected. I hope they didn't remove the... Alright, lots of screws are missing. Because there was an SSD drive right here, probably. Let's put it all down like that. Let's use the longer screws. Longer silver screws go in right here. Right there. Right there. And right there, good job. Alright, so my understanding, the little tiny silver square screw going in right here. Yep, that's right. And there should have been one silver screw going in right there. Right, this thing also broken, right? Yeah. Let's remove it all together. People over torque on those too much. Alright, so let's see if anything's bouncing. Nope, nothing is bouncing. Everything is out of here. Alright, and yeah, I just need another small tiny screw right there, which is not... Let's see if we can find something right there. Okay. Let's screw down this guy right here. So that the board wouldn't bounce around. Okay, so here. Those guys are nice and tight. And they are guided in the edges. Alright, so good job. Now let's close down this guy right here. Okay. And in theory, the whole thing should work. But in practice, it might not want to work because... make sure the hole aligns with the jack right there. In this case, it kind of aligns, but not... the way I like it, let's see. No, it aligns just fine. Let me, you know what, hold on. Let me disconnect this guy. Let me disconnect this guy and measure that there is no shortages at the jack level. At the level of the jack. Okay, let's see. You know what, I'm not sure if that data signal should short with the... Usually it shouldn't. You see, this is the data signal, which for some reason is shorting with the ground. Again, probably because the jack was bouncing around on the inside. I'm not sure why they had to do it like that. So... yeah, and I just realized that there is one component missing right here. Two components missing right there. One right there, one right there. So this probably not gonna work. I just wasted my time and your time. So you see right here, there was a component right there for sure. And there was a component right here for sure. Which components were there? You go figure. I want to clean up this stuff right here, and maybe there is a short right here, who knows. So, let me figure this thing out. Alright, so I cleaned up this mess, and it seems like there is only just one component missing. Those are the testing pins right here, but there was a component here of some sort, which is not there anymore. Again, that's the reason why I use Kapton tape right here, so that none of those components would get damaged and fly off the motherboard. But hopefully that's not really useful, because in a laptop, if you remove half of the components, everything should work. It's a laptop, you know. I mean, if you take the roof off of your house, it's still a house, right? Okay, so here, let's remove that. Let's do something like that. Like that. Like that. Nope, the casing is damaged pretty much all over the perimeter. So okay, looks good. Looks good. Let me screw in this the only screw that I got here with the laptop, and it doesn't even want to go in. All right, so now it's in. Good job. Let's screw one of those guys right there. Okay, and let's screw down one of those guys right here. All right, good job. Well, okay, let's put those pads back and let's see if it's gonna work. Another problem is the client uses the aftermarket power supply. And the reason we are in business is because of those aftermarket power supplies. You see, this is the aftermarket power supply. It has this huge tip, so any leverage right here on the left right side is gonna break the connector in the future for sure. So I'm not saying goodbye to this laptop. I'm just saying till next time. Thank you so much for using universal power supplies and buying them. And all right, so the power supply is tested out, okay, and let's connect it to the laptop right here, and hopefully it's gonna power up. And hopefully it's gonna work. Now the thing is, again, the jack was bouncing around, so it's I have no idea. And by the way, the laptop came in poorly packaged, so I don't know if anything else is gonna be broken here from the pack. Oh, and we got Republic of Games on the screen right there. Right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe. I will let you know which laptops you don't ever wanna buy, and thank you so much for watching. And you guys stay safe and have a good day. And right there it says just a moment, so it's loading up. So the laptop does work, and